Right, so we've arrived at Whitesprings on the Big Pit, and we're going to be here for 24 hours. I say we, it's me, and you can see little boy Wonder sitting in the chair waiting for me to put up the bivvy. You may recognise this peg from the last Big Perch fishing video, but yeah, so the thought is, if I can't catch carp and more than one perch in the day, what can I do in the night? Right. See when I get the bivvy up.
So we're at Whitesprings for one night. Steve's gonna be here for the morning, and Daddy's over there. And a little robin. And we're here for a day, and then 2 days. My peg is there, but we're gonna be sleeping there all day.
Right. Stop jiggling it around.
Stop filming now? Right then. No. So, the plan for today's session, I'm gonna fish for perch throughout the hours of daylight. And as soon as it gets dark, then I'm gonna put 2 carp rods out, fishing the Mistral's spirulina shellfish, and hopefully, the side of me, I've been chucking a little bit of bread out. Let's see if I can't get a carp off the top for William, or William try and get one off the top. He's had a bit of a go already, he just doesn't get it. You cast out a piece of bread and the carp taking it, so he reels it in. So one fish for the whole entire session for William off the surface will be a total success, so we'll see.
Right.
So first fish in the net. Carp fishing, the daytime perch fishing isn't going as well as hoped. We haven't had a single knock, and when I get something promising, what is it, Will?
A bream.
You like bream, don't you?
Yeah. I don't look.
That's okay. Right, let's drop them back in the net. Right, should we put it back? Right, first fish of the day going back. Did a good draw, Will. Keep it high. Keep it high.
Get a net!
Sorry, I'm one. Right. Let's go.
It's my wrist doing that.
Did it?
I hit my wrist, but I didn't cry. I've got one! And I reeled it on, you know, my own. Yes! Biffa, flappy fella.
He's gonna be a flappy fella. You didn't give him any room to play up there. Hold him like I told you before. Put your hands down. Put your hands down underneath him. And then you got him. Like that one. And.
Oh, Daddy's gonna flap.
Well, just lower him down if he's gonna flap. So, what do you think then, Will?
Good.
You caught that all by yourself on the surface, didn't you?
Yeah, and I reeled it in by.
Don't put your hands really close together, you're gonna drop him. Right, listen to me now. I need you to help. Hold him like that. Hold your hand. Open up your fingers like that.
Like that.
Yes. And then put your fingers through it. Put its fins through your fingers. At the front here. At the front. You're not listening. Yeah, put it through your fingers like that. There we go. You've got a better grip of him now, haven't you?
Yeah.
So, you caught that off a piece of bread off the top, didn't you?
Yep. And it's huge.
Do you want a photo? squat down a bit. I don't want you standing right up with him. That's a pretty impressive carp, Will. Smile.
Back now. My first fish. Draw means we got the same much fish.
There we go.
Also, my first.
Grace, will pop back, Will. And he's gone. Right.
My first carp.
Come here. Look at me. Look at the camera. So, what's it like to catch your first carp all by yourself?
Hard.
It was hard, was it?
Yeah.
He scared you, didn't he?
So I was like, what in this? I need a... First time I saw him, I was like, is that a fish on my rod? I was like, yes it is. And then I picked up the rod.
Brilliant.
Bit of hard fell on, a splashy fell out, and a flappy. Yep.
Don't hit the water, William. Stop hitting the water with your rod, man. If it's fish there, you'll scare them all away.
Swimming across the sea. Swimming across the sea. Oh, my little fish. It's tiny. Daddy's caught an eel.
Right.
Are you the first one?
Yeah, this is my first eel.
First ever eel.
No, it's not my first ever eel.
Yeah. Have you caught more eels than just one?
Oh.
He wants to eat the thing.
Yeah, let's hold him upside down, is there, for a sec. I know he's probably 3/4 of a pound.
Yeah, but... and a bit flappy. Flappy, flap, flap. I nearly caught
him. He bit me. Bit me on my finger there. Oh. Where?
Funny.
That's not funny, Will.
Yeah, it is.
So, horrible little thing. So, I'm going to show you in the net. 2 tons of slime and a little eel. That's quite adamant on biting your fingers every time you try to get close to it.
Eel.
A good grip on him. And he's turning right the way around in my hand. But I'm not going to try and let him bite me again.
But it's funny. But,
Eel. Time to put him back, I think. Lucky. Hopefully, next one will be a perch.
Yeah, hopefully.
Oh, I had something on then for a couple of seconds. Oh. Stuck on the rod rest. Stuck on the rod rest, Will. Stuck on the rod rest. William, it's stuck on the rod rest, the line is. William, use your ears now. It's on the rod rest. Right, cast now. There we go.
Oh my god.
Now flick the bait line and put it on the rod rest. Yes.
Daddy's cut a fish. Daddy's cut a fish. Hi. Hello.
So, here we go, we've got an eel. It's a better eel. Still not target species, but...
Bigger than the first eel. Oh, see him? Oh, he's doing a splash.
He's going for it, isn't he?
Yep.
I've got these things to swim back. Just hoping to bite through the line.
Yeah. He's under. Come on, Dad. I know if you've got it, haven't you?
That's a fiasco, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, and there he goes. Whoa. Back up. Ooh. He's a big eel, actually. Probably surprised, like 3 pounds.
I'll get someone to help, okay?
No, it's alright. You just keep going work.
Hey, Dad.
And he's just backwards trotted out of the nest again.
Come on, Dad, I know you can do it. He's in. Runner, you nearly. Runner,
look at that one.
What?
First.
He snapped it. Daddy snapped it.
That's a massive eel.
He snapped it because, you know what? I think you're joking.
Nope.
Dad.
The net. Last
day, I think. Dad, he's a friendly eel. Really? Yeah, he's letting me smooth him. What? He's good. He's a perfect eel, Daddy's. Caught, Dad.
This is probably one of the biggest freshwater eels I've ever landed. Right. I don't know how I'm going to hold this, but let's give it a quick weigh. I'm doing not a very good job of this. So he's coming up as... It is.
£3.
£3.01.
Well, he's not that heavy, I think.
I think it's one of the biggest eels I've ever caught, Will.
Dad, can I put him back? Put in that net.
Yep.
Or that net.
Oh, here we go. Jump out the way, Will.
That one.
Can you jump out the way?
He's a friendly eel.
So, here we go.
He's a big friendly eel.
That's a new Don't stop, Will, please. It's not a toy.
I know.
It's a £3 eel.
I'll hold the tail up.
Bit of a lump.
He's there huge.
William is just absolutely gobsmacked by this eel.
And he's mine, because Daddy's caught one already.
Alright, so you're claiming this one, are you, even though you're fishing with another rod?
Yeah, so I've got four fish.
Right, let's get a little photo of this and then put it back, is it?
Oh. He's gone.
He's acted so docile in the net, I didn't expect him to swim off so quickly. Alright.
And I'm good at him.
Okay, you want to tell me something?
Yeah.
Go on then.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
William.
William who?
William fishing, or piss after fishing. And I cast. Oh, sorry, but I cast my rod over.
All right. Well, see if you can catch another fish, right? Show me how perfect at fishing you are. Don't reel that in. Here we go. Boat lace number 3. William, just stop grabbing them. They'll cover you in slime.
No, I like holding him.
Do you want to put him back?
Yeah.
There we go.
No, I'm putting him.
Horrible now. Perch fishing has turned into eel fishing. Do you want to put him back, Will?
Yeah, we've caught 3 fish so far. Okay.
No, keep reeling. We got him. Just keep reeling the rod up high. Up high.
You've got this one, haven't you? Uh-huh. My best.
Well, you can't just abandon him.
Oh, I can't. I'm going to the next one.
Here he is. Come here, Will. William, you're going to miss him.
Who's that?
William. William, come here. Mm. I need someone.
Are you next?
You hooked a big fish here. Well, why did he give you the rod?
Bum bums.
William.
But I can't manage him.
Come here. He's come off.
Oh. Stupid fish.
You haven't hooked a fish. You hooked a fish that was on another rig. It's a proper nasty ball carp rig. Look. And you've hooked the lead core leader. Ah. There we go. Another little hybrid bream. Well, I think it's a proper bream. Just, they're like fat and stumpy in you. They're slipping back.
Fish number 4 for Daddy. Look at that. I'll put him in there.
No, stop. Stop shouting silly stuff, Noah. Please.
Okay. It's coming on, it's coming on. Soldiers, sinking in the cheekers. It's coming on, it's coming on.
Right. So, this is my perch fishing.
Perch fishing, or actually, eel fishing turns to perch again.
And we got a cracking little carp that's still bouncing round.
Bouncy guy.
Full linear scales, isn't it? But, happy with that.
Can I have gold folding?
You got him?
Yep, I got him.
Yeah, what do you think? Whoa, you're going to drop him?
Well, I can't hold him then.
So, I don't know. You're giving about 5-6 pounds.
Looks good.
Picked up the macro, I'd fought like hell for ages again. But I think we're going to pack in the perch fishing very soon. It's dusk, it's the right time of day, so I don't know. It won't be long before the carp rods go out anyway. Right, let's get this little booty back. Go on in. Let it go. Wait a sec now. What do I want you to do?
Oh, he's gone.
He's stuck in the net. He's stuck in the net. William.
Hang on. Let me have the net.
This, two hands, if you're going to hold him, you hold him like that, yes, like that. There we are, squat down so the camera can see you, and here we go. So, this is another little carp caught
by Daddy.
On perching, and who netted it for me?
Me.
Yeah, there we go. So another little duck.
Can you hold him?
I got him.
There's stuff in my ear.
What?
Like little ants.
Little ants in here, is it? Okay.
That's my bed.
Right then. That's a head torch in the face. It's come up to 10 o'clock. Got the kettle on. Having a bit to eat now. William's sitting in the background eating crisps. It's blind you. Yeah, so I managed to get the carp rods out. William's got one rod out. He's fishing a banana toffee pop up on a trod, and I've got the spirulina shellfish. Literally fed up and just put them in next to each other in the island. So I've got like a big bed of boilies out, and two baits sitting amongst them.
How many eels have you got?
I was on 4 or 5 eels. I dropped a couple at the end.
So you dropped one, and that was not good.
I didn't drop it though, it came off, didn't it?
Yeah, and then it flapped into the pond and then it flapped again, or jumped when it flapped, and then it got into the big deep pot.
Right, so we're going to have something to eat now, aren't we? And hopefully we'll get a couple of carp in the night. But it's been quite a hectic day's fishing. I know, with running back and forth with William, surface fishing for what he was. Went for literally the whole time we were here. I was just running back and forth, so I was missing bites all over the place. So I. And that sounds like rain. Right, let's get things packed up and in the bivvy. And we'll see you guys later. Right then, so first fish of the night so far, and it hasn't give up, and it's still going. I just weighed it out of curiosity because it just looked like the biggest stamp of what's in here, and it's £10.08. So there we go, lovely £10.08 common, and it's just started raining, so I need to get the cameras in. But yeah, nice to get a fish on the bank early. Nice double for the spirulina. Right, let's get it back. just past midnight. And I've got another little common in the net. I'm not going to do the whole sit down, hold it up. It's about £3, I think. Lovely condition, little common though. Fish number three since the carp rods went out. Lovely zipline here. This one's an immaculate little fish. Cross the fins in. Double zipline here. Lovely. The only little dots though, aren't they? Yeah, at least I'm catching it. We're coming up around about 1 a.m. now. And I'm wondering whether I should take the rods out. But this will come in. This one's scrapped like hell. He's still going for it. Hell of a lot of power in these little scrap, isn't there? But the spirulina. They're all over it. Right, so it's come up to about 2:30. Had about 4 or 5 false takes, and then this little bugger screams off again. I think that's what's that, six run? Right. It's coming up to 3 a.m. now. And this is either run 6 or 7, I can't remember. Yeah. Another 5 or 6 pounder. Give me the runaround proper. But, I think I'm going to reel the rods in now and get myself some sleep so we can catch some more fish in the morning. Right, good night. Oh, good morning. Right, so, oh Christ, I look rough. Last night I reeled both my rods in and I left William's rod with a banana toffee trod on it. And I don't know, I just wasn't expecting a trod to be picked up on you, but it has been. So, William, yeah. We're going to have to get this fish on the mat for you, and so you can have a look at your carp from our night fishing, and then wind it in because you're knackered. Yeah. But luckily that trod didn't go off till now. I'm wrecked. But yes. You right?
Yeah.
Right, so we'll get your fish onto the into the cradle, and we'll take some pictures for you, is it?
Yeah.
Come on to your fish then.
I want him the other way.
Want to give him a quick wave, is it? You know how big he is.
Okay, Dad. Fish I ever caught.
The same weight as the one I had last night.
Ah.
It's £10.
Maybe it's the same one.
£10, 8 ounces.
Ah, not bad then.
The one I had was a common. This is a mirror. Do you want to help picking it up?
No way. He's ate lots of boilies by the look.
Are you holding it well?
Close one.
Right.
If I didn't put him down, and then he'll flap in my face.
Alright, here we go. Kettle's on. Feels like it's taking a long time. While I'm waiting, I've chucked the carp rods back out. Give them a last sort of breather. I don't know. You spend all these years wanting more runs during the night, and when you literally, I think it was on 7 runs in the end, I give up. But yeah, just over the next peg then. William's surface fishing over there. He's whining and moaning. Obviously not enough sleep. What are you doing with that rod, Will? Yeah, you can't reel it sideways across the lake. You just have to wait until the fish come to it, okay? You're not listening, are you? I'll just leave you. Oh. There's my nighttime carp rods, or my morning carp rods. Oh, let's put that over there. Right, we've had our coffee. Steve, who's over on the peg, the other side, the kids. There. And just behind me on the other side of the lake, got Kevin and his little boy. So, yeah, William's been great. He hasn't listened to a word I said since I got up, so it's about the same as normal. But,
Hello.
Hello.
So we're, I'm going to flip over from mat carp rods now to the mat rods and see if I can't get a perch. Get something for all those eels yesterday. Right then, we'll see you later. Ready? So there's Steve up there. That's a giant perch, Steve.
Can I try and hold it on?
Wait a minute now. Great. Well, watch out, you two. Step aside.
That's it.
So.
That just looks massibly bigger than me.
Not even the way there. It's another three. I don't know if Dan's going to be able to put some photos on, but I came down a couple of days ago. I managed a really good session, which accumulated in a 4-pound, 2-ounce perch. Level my personal best, so of course it's brought us back down today. All excited. We've been here an hour and a half, and this probably gonna go 3 pounds. They're starting to fill up again. It's not one we've had before, we'd recognize that.
I've seen it in some of the photos on the website.
Can I hold them, Steve?
But no, you're not gonna hold this one, Will.
You got the sharp bits, you don't like these ones. Well, I'm going to give him a quick weigh and we'll go see how my day has started. No, nobody's holding it.
£3.09. 3.09. Okay. Right, so Steve's out of three. And all I'm having is little knocks, and I'm not connecting with anything. They're just little silvers pestering with the prawn. You can see William on the other side over there. He's pinched a float rod off Kevin, and he's had a couple of roach and stuff over there. But yeah, I'm concentrating. I'm going to get a perch now.
crab? Huh? Not talking to you. I had about 100 perch. I know, he's disgusting, isn't he? I had about nine carp last night, and I didn't sleep at all. That's all right.
Okay.
Drop in the side, like I said, Will.
I'm gonna guess.
Get out of the way, the camera.
She's
straight in front of us. What are we doing?
It's very
deep, isn't it?
It's four.
One. Well, you're fish, isn't it? Right, you're all right in front of the camera now. Look, you're looking at yourself.
Okay.
Watch out. Come out the way. Come out the way.
Stop.
Come out of the way.
You're ruining.
Hang on,
have a look at Steve. It's 4-3, I'll give him that.
I'm not giving him 4-3.
It is 4-3.
Ha ha! 4-3!
4.3.
Who would appear there?
No. This ain't one of them little fish. I want you two back to this side.
Yay! I'm allowed to hold
them. When are we doing the photos, okay? What? Steve's not having it.
No, I've got 4-4 on that.
4! You're going 4-4?
I'm going to get my digitals.
Okay. Left. Let it go.
Hey!
Don't go touch the ball.
Two.
Go.
Three.
Just past the line, that.
Three. If you're looking at that straight.
That's 4-3, Steve.
It's 4-2.
It's 4-3.
It's 4-2.
4-2. 4-3. 4-3.
Hold it. Right. Kids out the way.
I want to hold it now.
Right.
Right. Well, I'm happy with 4-2. If I go 4-3, it only makes it harder to beat.
True. It's a beast, Dan.
Yes.
I'm not sure, that's not the thing first.
Okay. So,
other way for me.
This is perch of a lifetime. So, look at that.
I'll just tailor.
£4.3. £4.2 of Whitesprings perch.
I tell you what, once that's... when that stomach's full, that's every bit of five, isn't it? But that's a big frigged fish. That mate, awesome.
Right. I'll have to get some photos of this. Cheers, Will.
Can you give you a hug?
Yeah.
Well done, Will. Right, where's your camera, Dan?
Get some snaps. Just before we leave, should I sneak in this peg as well?
Yeah, I think I have a tidy camera and the tripod, don't I?
Oh, right. Get the net head out. Well and truly, a perch of a lifetime.
Oh, absolutely.
But, look at that. It's longer than the tip of my fingers to the middle of my forearm. Your perch is... I couldn't even gauge. But, time to say goodbye. Let's get the camera down so I can see it going.
Piece. That's why we come to Whitesprings. Two fours in the space of 3 days. Friday, come in there. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Two fours in the space of 3 days.
Right. So, fishing's been really hard all day. And I'm literally... A couple of guys from the Freshwater Facebook group turned up. And they've been struggling with little silvers, little perch and stuff like that. I really just didn't expect that. I've literally gone from multiple runs last night, giving up carp fishing because it was just, I needed sleep, to getting up this morning and blanking. But it was worth it. It was worth it. Right. I got to start packing down and I've got some shopping to do for the week. Back to reality. I know, I'll have to get you a little float rod. I haven't got money for my one today, though. You want to tip that rod? Ooh. Right then. So, blogging out in the car, boiling hot summer's day. Yeah. Brilliant sort of evening. PB Eel. Night was non-stop. Carp all night. And then this morning, the sun came out and it just died. What do you think, Will?
Good.
Did you have a good time?
Yeah.
And Kevin's kids came down. You played for hours with them, but you were getting a bit noisy in the end, weren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, but we had a good time, didn't we? And Steve had that big perch as well, didn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Just one fish he's caught for us.
Well, no, he just caught one. It's mad that today there has been little silvers out and two big perch, and that is it. I don't know what's wrong with the weather or the sun or anything, but it's just killed it. But I'm just glad one of those perch came to my rod. Right. I think that's it, is it? We better get home.
And Daddy caught 3 eels.
Yeah, well, 4 eels. Yeah. Doesn't matter. All right, then. I'll catch you next time we're on the bank. Ta-da!
Bye.